specialized paramedic, any place, anytime, anywhere. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the presentation of the Legion of Merit. This is to serve by the President of the United States of America, authorized by Act of Congress, July 20, 1942, as awarded the Legion of Merit, 2nd Oak Leaf Cluster, Colonel Kenneth J. Daniels, for exceptional meritorious conduct and performance of outstanding services. Colonel Kenneth J. Daniels distinguished himself by exceptionally meritorious conduct the performance of outstanding service to the United States as commander of 24th Special Operations Wing, Grover Field, Florida, from 4 June 2021 to 29 June 2023. During this period, the leadership, exemplary foresight, and ceaseless efforts consistently demonstrated by Colonel Daniels resulted in significant contributions to the warfighting capability and overall success of the wing. Colonel Daniels was responsible for the organizing, training, and equipping the most highly decorated group of airmen since the Vietnam War. His efforts also enhanced special tactics recruiting, resiliency, and family support. After his while providing oversight to the Air Force's premier Gold Star Family Program. He oversaw the establishment of the Air Force's first of its kind Center for Medical Immigration, ensuring readiness of 750 medics. This effort resolved a 10-year shortfall advanced tactical practitioner certifications and paramedic professions for the command. Additionally, Colonel Daniels' exceptional leadership was pivotal in leading the enterprise to the top-to-bottom reorganization of the command's force generation model, enhancing their ability to provide highly trained and validated ground forces to support various combat missions across 5 combatant commands. Furthermore, he established the command's first special operations forces basic interoperability standard, governing the sensitive activities, training program, while ensuring readiness of the command's premier regular warfare ground force. In addition, his wing led the command's ground response to 7 Secretary of Defense task missions, including providing direct support to the 2021 Haiti earthquake relief mission. His wing surveyed multiple airfields and controlled air operations, making it possible critical humanitarian relief to reach thousands of displaced persons impacted by the earthquake and ensuring the rapid evacuation of 15,000 Americans and 223 critical aviation patients. Finally, over the past 24 months, Colonel Daniels' wing graduated 92 new special tactics operators, trained 307 special operations tactical air controllers, and earned 2 Silver Stars, 20 Bronze Star Medals, and 5 Air Force Level Awards, and 11 Command Level Awards. The superior initiative, outstanding leadership, and personal endeavor displayed by Colonel Daniels reflect great credit upon himself and the United States Air Force. Thank you, General Powerfine. Ladies and gentlemen, the commander of 24th Special Operations Command, Colonel Jason Daniels.
Really appreciate your presence. It is important for the two of us. It means something to us and honors us, but it is important to show respect for this unit as a whole, so we appreciate you being here. Sir, thank you for your words. Probably overly kind, but I do appreciate it. Special thanks to Steve Haggett, I don't know if you can hear me over there, and his entire team for putting this together. That includes our team within the 2-4 Sal, but also the Honor Guard and Comm Squadron from the 1st Sal. So thank you all for what you did to put this together today. So there are a lot of thoughts and emotions streaming through my head this morning, but the most prevalent one is that the Lord has so richly blessed me in so many ways. I stand here with an overwhelming feeling of thanksgiving. And so with that sentiment, I just say thanks to several people. So for my parents who provided an excellent example growing up in a foundation in biblical values, for a wife who was independent and supportive, for kids who love Jesus and were healthy and smart, for friends across the world, made from within the Special Tactics community and then Air Commando community, specifically for the chance to serve with, lead, and command Special Tactics Airmen for the last couple of decades. And then specifically for the opportunity to command this unit for the past 2 years. For bosses like Lieutenant General Slate and Lieutenant General Bonnefine for giving me the opportunity and trusting me to do so. And for past leaders and supervisors who are too numerous to name, who have contributed to taking a very rough product and turning it into something capable of commanding the wing. A few of those in the crowd today I will point out as representatives of the entire community. So General Rosnick, thank you for being here today, sir. General Armfield, RZ in the back there. I saw Mike Ramos as well. Numerous others, but I'll go all the way back to NDOC, Bill White and Tony Alexander, who were also who were NCOs at the time and retired 06s and 06s now. So a pretty large span of folks. Really appreciate all you guys. For great relationships with the host wing for Sal and with the MATCHCOM staff, very thankful for the talented and dedicated detachment, squadron, and group leadership teams from across the wing. And then really thankful for the entire 2-4 Sal staff as a whole. And in particular, thanks to those who most directly supported me here in the front office. I will name those each one. So Steve Hackett, James Byrne, Dave Kennedy, and Dan Bieber, Jeff Thielen, and Josh Singh. Those are the executives, officers, and assistants for Command Chief and I. Rebecca Miner, Captain Williams, secretaries, Chris Berger, and Bruce Dixon, directors of staff. And then Command Chief partners, Allison Black and Buck Hodgkinson, both here today. As well as incredible command chiefs in Chris Grove and Clint Campbell. And they represent, you know, the lifeblood of our community, our enlisted force. Absolutely great representatives of that. So this wing, and the Special Tactics Community, which as General Byron said, is AFSOC's ground component and is the U.S. Air Force's Special Operations ground component. We live by the core values of the U.S. Air Force. Integrity first, for self, excellence, and honor. These are core values that have aligned with my own and resonated with me ever since General Fogelman introduced them when I was a kid at the Air Force Academy. Additionally, the attributes that we as a community in the Special Tactics world assess and select for and live by, attributes like problem solving, teamwork, and the ability to handle stress and work well under stress, they set a standard for everyone in the organization to raise everyone's game. They are why General Fenton, the Special Operations Command, 4-star boss right now, says that the Special Operations Command as a whole is built for this era. We are built for this era partially because of our experiences over the past 20 years and what we've learned, but also because of those attributes and core values that we live by. This wing also takes extreme ownership of contributing to the complex challenges of balancing, keeping terrorists at bay, while also navigating even higher stakes endeavor of competing with our peer and near-peer adversaries. Over the last 2 years, this wing has responded to numerous crises, as detailed by General Byron. I added one more in the Haiti disaster relief response. Executed a variety of missions across Africa, the Middle East, Europe, South America, and Asia, plan and gain approval from geographic combatant commanders to execute high biz and high stakes missions, develop cutting edge technology and sensitive options to ensure access to contested areas, transformed from primarily focusing on insurgencies and terrorists to primarily focusing on strategic competition, helped partner nations defend their borders, fight terrorism, and draw closer relationships with the United States, and led AFSOC's transition from a legacy colonel-led deployed mission command structure to a new lieutenant colonel-led structure that is trained and generated as a team and charged with solving problems with combatant commanders. Amongst all that, you also began new traditions in the Chapman competition to recognize our best operators and support personnel across the wing and the special tactics community. And you also simultaneously professionalize our operations and risk management processes. You've done all these things through uncertainty, ambiguity, and even tragedy. During the past 2 years, the wing also was entrusted by AFSOC to take on two new missions. First, it added a 54-person deployment cell, which provides expeditionary logistics and bear basing support to the joint force on a moment's notice. Additionally, the 24 South took lead on standing up AFSOC's Greek theater engagement capability. This detachment took in much of the legacy combat aviation advisor capability, which had to re-envision itself, and it did a very difficult thing in changing mission and standing up a new unit. I'm extremely proud of the airmen of both of these units for their resiliency and willingness to change, and to the 24 South staff and the rest of the wing for wrapping our arms around them and helping these air commandos advance the ball with critical capabilities. So as the 24 South transitions commanders today, it's very clear to me that AFSOC picked the right person for the job. David Ruger is experienced, talented, grounded, extremely bright. He lets reason guide his decisions, and he's a man of character. In other words, he's exactly what this wing needs. DM, it's an incredible honor to hand the unit over to you, particularly because I had a very small part in your development and mentorship along the way. 1 year work, but still, counting. You know, the goal as leaders when we do that is that the people coming behind us will be better than we were. And I have no doubt that will be true in your case. The opportunity to command this wing and serve as airman has been the greatest honor of my career, and I would certainly trust it will be for you also. So thank you all for being here again to celebrate this occasion with us. It is truly an honor.
To the AFSOC command team, General Byron, General Governor's office, Chief Green. Thank you for your trust in allowing me the privilege to serve such an outstanding group of air commanders at the 24th Special Operations Wing. We look forward to executing your vision as part of the Air Force and ASOP team. Mrs. Byron, ma'am, thank you for your friendship with Jen. I know she values and sincerely appreciates your mentorship. Whether in attendance or tuning in virtually, thank you to all the distinguished military and civilian guests, commanders and chiefs, and especially my friends and family who traveled from Kentucky, Texas, and Chicago. As I look across the crowd, it is without a doubt the who's who of ASOP legends. Whether a friend, mentor, or colleague, many of you have impacted me in deeply meaningful ways. And I recognize that I would not be up here if it weren't for your investment in me as a leader. Know that you all taught me more than I could ever repay, but I intend to pay it forward every day that I'm in this role. To my wife, Jen, you've also carried the burden of military service. You've endured dozens of months alone, raising kids and parenting alone, celebrating birthdays, anniversaries, and holidays alone. I'm truly blessed to have you as my secret weapon. We served together in our Air Force career, and I'm excited about what lies ahead. Maverick and McKenna, thanks for letting your dad be with us. When you're older, I hope you realize and appreciate your service to the nation. Colonel Black and Chief Miner, you've been examples of how to be a successful command team and lead a beast of a wing at the first sound. Thanks for letting me be the third wheel to your dynamic duo. And since I'm not moving far, just know that you'll be inheriting a demanding tenant who knows where you hide all the skeletons. Colonel Mannings, thanks for being a career-long mentor and friend, always willing to guide me in the right direction. Your focus on warfighting and the warfighter are what sets you apart. ASOP and the Joint Force is better with officers like you in leadership roles. I know the 24th SAO has been led well, and I look forward to building on the momentum you've created in the wing. Julie, you met Jen 14 years ago over the phone and became fast friends. Last year, you finally met in person, and you both unwittingly showed up wearing the exact same outfit. Jen came home that day and said, "She's my spirit animal." Thank you for your friendship and support to Jen. Chief Five Star Campbell Chance, Colonel Hutchinson, and Aaron, I'm excited to work with you as we move the wing into the future. To the men and women of the 24th Special Operations Wing, Jen and I look forward to working for you. Every day, we must earn the distinction as our Air Force's premier ground special operations force. I'm optimistic about our future because of you, incredible people that fill our ranks. I aim to earn your trust as we work together to solve our nation's toughest problems. Lastly, it's important to honor our Gold Star families of those who have made the ultimate sacrifice. We will never stop saying the names of our fallen. We will never forget those who stepped up and put it on the line when it mattered most. Doing this gives us strength in the face of adversity. And in this vein, I will close with a story. Winston Churchill was referred to as the Lion of England. And while he wasn't exactly a humble guy, he did push back from that moniker a bit. Instead, Churchill said, "It is the people of England who are the lion, but history has called upon me to deliver the war." To every member of the ASOP team and the 24th SAO, I encourage you to think about your place in history. It will call on each of you in some way, today, tomorrow, next month. But I assure you, it will call. History will call on you, like it did with Tim Davis, Andy Carvell, Matt Rowe, and many others who gave the ultimate sacrifice. And like them, when history calls on you, when you are tapped on the shoulder, will you be ready? Will you be willing to deliver the war our nation needs? Thank you.